Welcome back. So you worked a little on the concept of orthogonal projections. Good. The fact that U1 is a projection of U onto V implies that U1 is parallel to V. So it is a scalar multiple of V, which amounts to saying that U1 equals C times V for some scalar C. Since U1 plus U2 equals U, we can conclude that U2 equals U minus U1. Furthermore, U2 and V are orthogonal. This implies that the dot product of U2 and V equals 0. Plugging these in, we find the inner product of U minus CV and V equals 0. So, well, since U and V are known, this equation contains only one unknown variable, namely C. This means that we can solve for C and thus obtain U1, the projection of U onto V, which is what this was all about in the first place. By using the mathematical rules of the dot product, you can rewrite the equation as the dot product of U and V minus the dot product of CV and V equals 0. A slight modification yields C times the dot product of V and itself equals the dot product of U and V. Consequently, C is equal to the dot product of U and V divided by the dot product of V and itself, or equivalently, C equals the dot product of U and V divided by the square of the length of V. So you found that U1, the orthogonal projection of U onto V, equals the vector V scaled by the dot product of U and V divided by the square of the length of V. The signed magnitude of the orthogonal projection of U onto V is called the scalar projection of U onto V. In fact, the absolute value of the scalar projection is equal to the length of the orthogonal projection. The proof of this statement is left to you as one of the exercises. Let's now return to our moving car. Imagine the constant force F is given by the vector -3, 4 and the displacement vector S by -5, 0. Compute the resultant force F1 in the direction of S, where F1 equals C times S and C equals the dot product of F and S divided by the length of F squared. The dot product of F and S is equal to 15. The length of F is equal to the square root of 9 plus 16, which is 5. So the scalar C is equal to 0.6. This means that the vector F1, the projection of F onto S, is equal to 0.6 times S. The fact that the scalar projection is a signed magnitude can be seen from the relationship between the scalar projection and the inner product of U and V. This, as you know from the geometric definition of the dot product, is equal to the length of U times the length of V times the cosine of the angle between U and V divided by the length of V, which is equal to the length of U times the cosine of alpha. Indeed, if the angle is obtuse, that is greater than pi over 2, the cosine is smaller than 0, making C negative. You now know how to calculate orthogonal projections and scalar projections. The orthogonal projection of U onto V is a vector in the direction of V, which is the result of walking from U in a direction perpendicular to V. The scalar projection of U onto V is a scalar giving the signed length of the orthogonal projections. Please work on the exercises following this video to actually become able to compute these in any given situation. Thank you for watching.